whenever we have any problem of the sort Ax equal to b, we can employ the method such as Gauss elimination. To solve a general problem, what we just saw a few minutes back is that Gauss elimination is highly computationally intensive method. It's computationally intensive because the number of computation required for Gauss elimination are proportional to n to the power 3, okay, where n is the number of variables in the vector x that we are solving for. So, for example, if n equal to 10, we have the number of computations that are required in order to use Gauss elimination are of the order of 1000, okay. However, from n equal to 10, we go to a slightly larger problem with say n equal to say 100. This particular, the number of computations that are required increases from 1000 to 1 million, and that is because Gauss elimination scales as n to the power 3. Now, if from n equal to 100, if we go to n equal to 1000, the amount of computation required is going to be 10 to the power 9. So, as we increase the number of equations that we are solving, the amount of effort required in Gauss elimination increases very rapidly, okay. Now, for a general purpose problem Ax equal to b, we do not have a choice because Gauss elimination turns out to be one of the more efficient ways of solving a general purpose problem Ax equal to b. However, a lot of problems of interest to engineers, chemical engineers, mechanical engineers and so on, are not a general purpose problem. They have a specific structure, okay, and they have a structure what is known as a banded structure. Or a sparse structure, okay. So, this matrix A is not a full matrix, but it has a certain type of structure, and where does that structure comes from, I will come to that in a couple of minutes. But because it has a certain structure, there are certain properties of that structure that we can actually exploit, and that is exploited in some of the more efficient ways of solving. Those are banded solvers as they are called. A specific example that we are going to take of the banded solver today is called a tri-diagonal matrix algorithm, okay. And a tri-diagonal matrix algorithm is applicable to what are known as tri-diagonal matrices. So, let me come to what tri-diagonal matrices really are and how these tri-diagonal matrices come into existence for a typical problem that we see in chemical engineering, okay. So, the tri-diagonal matrix structure is of the form. So, this is what we have, the matrix A is going to be. The in the tri-diagonal structure, the diagonal elements of the matrix may be non-zero. One more set of elements just below the diagonal may be non-zero. One more set of elements just above the diagonal may be non-zero, whereas rest all the elements in this matrix are going to be 0. An example of this could be, for example, you can have a matrix say A11, A12, 0, 0. And so on up to 0, A21, A22, A23, 0, and rest everything else is going to be 0. Now, this particular guy is two locations off of the diagonal, therefore, this guy is going to be 0. Then we will have A32, A33, A34, and rest everything will be 0, and so on, we will have 0, 0, 0. 0 and so on up to ANN, and there will be over here, this term is going to be AN minus 1 comma N, rest everything in this particular row is going to be 0. So, this is a tri-diagonal structure. As we can see over here, this particular diagonal may be non-zero, this super diagonal element may be non-zero, and this sub-diagonal elements may be non-zero. Everything else in this structure is zeros. Okay, so again, this is called a diagonal. This is going is what is known as a super diagonal. And this is going to be subdiagonal. Okay. And if we have one diagonal element, one super and one subdiagonal element, what we actually get is a tri-diagonal matrix. Okay. And going further, taking this concept of tri-diagonal further, we could basically also have a banded diagonal matrix or a banded matrix. Okay, where there would be one diagonal element and more than one super diagonal elements and more than one sub diagonal elements. So for example, there might be two super diagonal elements, two sub diagonal elements, and rest everything else might be zero. Now these are special structures because we know a priori that everything over here is going to be zero and everything over here is going to be zero. The computational load for this can be reduced quite significantly compared to a general Gauss elimination method. Okay. So if we were to solve problem AX equal to B, where A has a tri-diagonal structure, okay, then we can use the TDMA matrix, TDMA method, tri-diagonal matrix algorithm, as I had said earlier. We can use this TDMA method to reduce the amount of effort from n to the power 3 to n to the power 1, and I will show that in a few minutes. Okay. Okay, it's common in lot of engineering problems. Okay, especially when we are going to express a model for an engineering problem in terms of a differential equation. Okay. We will come to this in more details in module 7, module 8 and module 9 of this particular lecture series. Let's consider a rod that is losing heat to the surroundings, and let the surroundings be at 25 degrees Celsius. One end of the rod, let's say, is heated and kept at say 100 degrees Celsius, and let's say the other end of the rod is kept at 25 degrees Celsius, and we want to find out how the temperature varies in this particular rod. Now this is a straightforward engineering problem which results in what is known as ordinary differential equations, boundary value problem, and under steady state this equation ends up being 0 equal to k d square t by dx square minus h a multiplied by t minus 25 equal to 0. Okay. So this is the conduction term and this is the heat loss term that comes over here. Now what we can rewrite this entire problem as d square t by dx squared equal to h a by k t minus 25. Okay. So this is going to be the overall differential equation, where one end of the rod is kept at 100 Celsius, the other end of the rod is kept at 25 degrees Celsius. Okay, and when we rewrite this particular equation, what we are going to do is we are going to discretize this particular rod in multiple segments, and we can discretize this in n minus 1 segments. Okay, and when we do that, we will result, what we will get is we will get n equations in n unknowns, and those equations, and I am not going to derive them right now, but I am just going to state them very quickly. We will do the derivation in module 8 of this particular course, module 8 lecture 2 onwards we will take that derivation. Our T1, that is temperature at the first end, is going to be equal to 100. Okay, for our second segment we are going to use basically this equation, and we are going to expand it using the numerical using the derivatives definition at this particular location. So if this location is location 2, then d square t by dx square is going to be t3 minus 2t2 plus t1 divided by this, let us call this as delta x, so divided by delta x squared. Okay, so what we will have is we will have T3 minus 2T2 plus T1 divided by delta x squared is going to be equal to HA divided by K multiplied by T2 minus 25. Okay, and I take delta x squared on to the other side, I will be I'll basically get T3 minus 2T2 plus T1 equal to HA delta x squared by K T2 minus 25. Let us call this guy as alpha. Okay, so we will get this as alpha T2 minus alpha multiplied by 25, let us call 25 alpha as nothing but beta, so where beta equal to 25 alpha. Okay, so this is what we will get. We will rearrange this, we will take T2 onto, or rather we will take beta onto the other side, and these guys we will take onto the right hand side, and we will get beta is going to be equal to minus T1 plus 2 plus alpha T2 minus T3 is going to be equal to beta. Okay, so this is what we are going to get. When we redo this particular procedure for the third element, we are going to get beta equal to minus T2 plus 2 plus alpha T3 minus T4 equal to this left hand side, so on and so forth, or we will get beta equal to minus T I minus 1 plus 2 plus alpha times T I minus T I plus 1. Okay, so now our overall structure of our A matrix is going to be determined as follows. Let us define x equal to nothing but t1, t2 and so on up to tn. Okay, then our equations can be written in the form like this. So the first equation is t1 equal to 100, or it is going to be 1, 0, 0 and so on up to 0 multiplied by t1, t2 and so on up to tn equal to 100. Okay, our second equation is going to be minus 1, 2 plus alpha minus 1, and rest everything is going to be 0. So it is going to be minus 1, 2 plus alpha. I will just rewrite this so that there is enough space for me to write everything. Okay, 2 plus alpha minus 1, and rest everything is going to be 0, and over here we will have 0 minus 1, 2 plus alpha minus 1, and then everything is going to be 0, and this will follow in the subdiagonal element, this will follow in the diagonal element, this will follow in the super diagonal element, everything else will be zeros over here, and the last equation is going to be Tn equal to 30 Tn equal to 25, which is going to be just this 1 multiplied by Tm equal to 25. And all these guys are going to be populated by the left hand side, which is going to be beta and so on. Okay. So this is going to be the overall structure. Our A matrix has the tri-diagonal structure. The tri-diagonal structure, if we come and look over here, this was what the tri-diagonal structure was. Okay. So we have the diagonal element, the super diagonal element and the sub diagonal element. All the diagonal elements are 2 plus alpha except for A11 and ANN. All the super diagonal elements are going to be equal to minus 1 except the first guy. Okay. All the sub diagonal elements are again going to be minus 1 except the last guy, which is 0. Okay. So this is a tri-diagonal matrix structure that comes in because of the heat conduction problem. Similar tri-diagonal structures you will get from a plug flow reactor problem or a fixed bed reactor problem or a membrane problem where we are going to, if we were to model say reverse osmosis process in a membrane, we will get a similar type of model and so on and so forth. So we are going to get tri-diagonal matrix type of structures in a lot of problems of interest.